is here, and he's talking with our own Jen Frederick about his upcoming movie, Charlie St. Cloud. Now, I understand he is in the building. Yes, he is. Oh, look at that hair. This is in our green room. He's getting ready. And from what I hear already, he's a really nice guy. We've got teenage girls sitting outside the studio. Uh-huh. Jen Frederick there holding it down. So you're going to meet
Is that the right situation?
I know, right? Look at that hair. I can't get over that hair.
No.
Stay with us.
Nothing right.
He's cute. Teenage girls.
They're outside. No, well, I'm looking out the window, and they're all taking pictures through the glass.
You should see them. And it's like, you should, look
and
at them.
There's our lobby.
And some of them in the lobby. What does that feel like to have people just kind of stare at you?
Well, let me tell you, Chanel.
All right. Zac Efron, if you haven't heard, starring in a new movie. It's called Charlie St. Cloud.
Yeah, he plays a big brother with a broken heart.
Good morning, Zac Efron.
Morning.
I hate to have that abrupt start to an interview. How are you, first of all?
Great. I know that was so dramatic for an intro, but no, it's good. Everything's great.
Yeah. Right. Okay, so there's people outside. There's people in the lobby, as we mentioned. The people outside have a copy of the book, but they've refused to read it. They want to see the movie that comes out on the 30th first before they read this book. You think that's cool?
Yeah, that's a bit backward, but hey, yeah, I'm all for it. I'm all for it. That's good.
Well, you know, Chanel was talking about it. When you see all these fans, there's people in the studio with us now, there's people out the window, people, it's pretty cool, right?
It's great. You know, that's one thing that's been so fun about this whole ride is the dedication from fans. You know, it's been unbelievable. Their support, they show up to, you know, gosh, it's so early right now, there's no way I'd be out of bed. And they're all out here, you know, rooting me on, so it's great.
And I have to say, when you turned around and you saw the people in the window, you looked genuinely happy to see them, that they were here. It's not an act.
No, not at all.
Okay.
No, I'm very excited.
Let's talk about your acting. Why this role? What did you like about this role?
You know, there's a lot of different reasons, but I think first and foremost, it really sort of struck an emotional chord with me. I have a little brother myself. He's 17 years old.
Aww.
Oh, no, sorry, he's 18. I always do that. I don't know why I keep doing that. He's 18.
He'll like you for it later.
I don't know. We'll see. You know, we were best friends growing up. And right now we're getting to that place where, you know, I see him as more of a real person than just my little brother.
Yeah.
So I read this script, and a great director, Burr Steers, who directed 17 Again,
mm-hmm.
said that he was interested in doing it, and it all just sort of fell into place. So the planets kind of aligned, and you know, very, very happy.
So in this movie, and obviously 17 Again and High School Musical, you're the good guy. Everyone likes you. You've got the cute girlfriend, the whole thing. Are you ever going to go for the bad guy role? Are you not ready for that yet?
No, I hope so. I mean, it'll all come with time, I guess, and different, you know, chances and opportunities. I would love to go there,
mm-hmm.
But it's finding the right way to do it. And, you know, a cool enough character, I think.
Cool enough character. Yeah, someone who could appreciate your hair. It's all spiked up this morning.
Oh, yeah, it is. You noticed.
Yeah, it's good. All right, so I got to give people more of this movie because it's a really great movie.
Great.
And I don't know if you've heard, but a lot of women think you're cute.
Oh, great.
Yeah, cool. It's probably new to you.
Oh, that's cool.
So let's let the people see you and your love interest in the movie,
cool,
okay?
Cool, thank you.
You're kissing someone who isn't your girlfriend. Okay, how freaky is that when you have to do that? I know it's a role, you're playing a role, but when you obviously knew you were going to have to work the moves on her,
mm-hmm.
were you okay with that?
Yeah. Well, me and Amanda by now are great friends.
Yeah.
You know, and it's not hard. I mean, once you get there and you're in the movie, you know.
Yeah.
You have that connection, so
that's
all
cool.
Out, yeah.
One thing that a lot of people are asking this morning on Twitter: Are you traveling with anyone in particular today?
Not yet. Not on this leg.
Okay.
I'm going back to LA, so I don't know. We'll see for the rest of the trip what happens.
Okay. Vanessa, but that's it. Okay. Now here's the question I have. Are you ready?
Yeah.
This is the tough part.
All right.
You should be blushing, and you are, and I'm happy.
Okay.
My husband's out of town for the week.
Oh gosh.
And it's not what you think.
Uh-huh.
I'm not going to try and put the moves on you.
Oh, okay.
I want him to look like this someday. What do I feed him? What do I buy at the grocery store so that my husband will someday look like this? I mean, is it like P90X? Is this broccoli? Is it no beer? Please give me the secrets to turn my husband into you.
I don't know.
And by the way, he's 44.
Send him to Hawaii and like, you know, give him a hotel room, and then don't tell him there's paparazzi on the beach, and then just go buy him a cool pair of board shorts. That should
Listen,
suffice.
He knows there's no paparazzi on the beach. When we go anywhere, there's no paparazzi. Like, are you working out every day? Is this diet? Is it genetics? I need to know.
You know, I like to stay active, and you know, especially when you're doing press, I have to have that zen sort of moment to kind of just relax and forget about everything. So, I mean, last night I went for a run for about a half hour.
In Philadelphia?
Yeah. Well, it was like 10:30 at night, so I just went in the hotel.
Oh, on the treadmill.
Yeah, I want to do the Rocky Steps while I'm here.
I'll take you there if you want me to.
Really? Oh,
yeah, I'm available.
That'd be so great. Seriously, I'm not joking. No, I'd love
to. And you know what? I'll do it in these shoes. I beat a Philadelphia Eagle. Brent Celek, are you a sports guy?
Yeah, yeah.
One time when it was his rookie season here, I beat him. I was in flip-flops, so I am not to be messed with, Zac Efron.
Oh, man. I don't know if I believe you. That's amazing.
Oh, yeah, I still know. Okay, so you're going to get a cheesesteak.
Yeah.
We've talked about this. Mm-hmm. You watch the Travel Channel, so you know of Geno's, you know of Pat's.
Yes, I know about the whole rivalry, everything.
Yeah, but I said you might want to try Jim's.
Yeah.
The problem with that, because I'm going to help you because we're best friends now.
Yeah.
There's lots of girls on South Street.
Oh, really?
There might be a scene. So you got to, like, duck in, do your movie star thing, and come back out. You think you can handle that?
I think I can handle it. Well, now it might be kind of tough. I'm not sure. We just said on TV, but we'll see. I'm going to try and sneak in.
Hey, yeah. Listen, tell us again when the movie opens.
July 30th.
Okay. And it's a good chick flick. However, the publicists are going to nod their heads. It'd be good for guys, too, because they could have a nice ending after the chick flick.
Not even better. Mm-hmm. It's great for whole families.
Whole families, yeah, the big brother thing.
Exactly.
All right, give me a high five.
High five.
You survived. Should we wave to the fans?
We should,
guys.
Indeed.
They're watching you out on the monitor. Thanks for coming in, and welcome to Philadelphia.
Thank you very much.
Okay?
Good to be here. Cool.
Okay, it's over. Jack. Zach and I have had our fun. Sue,
let's go
over to you. We did okay?
It was great.
Almost. Okay, almost my turn.
He's super nice. Yeah. He's Zac Efron.
Yeah. Oh, thank
you. Cute.
Cool.
All right, Cesario, top that.
I have to talk now.